Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Some people do not like the way they look. And some people look so much into the mirror that they begin to find fault with everything and anything. So remember, Allah Almighty has not created us on earth in a perfect way because He's kept perfection for the hereafter. On earth, He's made us human beings. Humans are actually flawed. The thinking is limited, the capacity is limited, we only have 5 senses. Whereas in the hereafter, we can have unlimited senses. We would be able to hear and see things that we cannot hear and see with the limited senses we have right now. There are frequencies in the air and there are things that are flying around that we cannot see. We would either need microscopes or so many other apparatuses. But what is definitely clear is even with all of that, there are things that we still are unable to see. So imagine Allah Almighty wants us to just look at ourselves and love ourselves the way He made us. He chose our skin tone. He chose the type of hair we're going to have. In fact, the race, the ethnicity chosen by Allah. And each race or ethnicity is known in a certain way. Allah says, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. We created you from a male and a female, Adam and Eve. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا. And we made you into different peoples and tribes in order for you to know one another, to recognize one another. You can recognize a person coming from this continent or that race or this ethnicity because that's how Allah made them. You have to love yourself. If your eyes are a certain way, alhamdulillah. If your hair or your height or your complexion is a certain way, alhamdulillah. Praise Allah. The world is temporary. 70 years. 60 years, 80 years, not really much more than that. In fact, in many cases, much less than that. And in this short time, we begin to dislike ourselves to the degree that we don't realize this body is something temporary that was given to us to go through a phase of our existence known as life on earth, which is a few decades, perhaps on average. And after that, we're going to separate. The soul and the body is going to be separated. That body is going to go back into the earth. And the soul goes back to its maker and is dealt with. Preparation for the day of judgment and thereafter going in, inshallah, into paradise by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nonetheless, we should realize that in the process, when people forget that they have this temporary body that doesn't actually belong to them permanently. When people forget that, they begin to do things to it that really will bother them long term. So you don't like your lips, you're going to put huge fillers, it's not going to look normal. You don't like, for example, your nose, you're going to change it and shape it. And many people have been depressed as a result of it. In fact, I know of people who've committed suicide as a result of what's called a nose job that went wrong, and many of them do go wrong. Yes, if there is a necessity, then you should do it. If it is something abnormal, you have an option of doing it and correcting it or bringing it back to normal. But playing with something that is generally normal is not part of your connection with Allah. It does not depict a proper connection with your Maker. You haven't understood why Allah has created us on earth. There's no perfection. You will find flaws in every single thing. Because your eyes, if you look every day into the mirror, nobody's ever noticed what you noticed. Because you're looking too much. You're looking too hard. Perhaps you're not saying the prayer, Oh Allah, I thank you for what you've given me. Oh Allah, in the same way you've beautified me externally, beautify me internally. That's the dua of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So, your hair, alhamdulillah, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your teeth, mashallah. If, yes, there is something wrong, you want to straighten them, by all means. But if there's nothing wrong with them and you just want to tamper with it, you may end up regretting more than anything else. So it's not a good sign to become obsessed with the way you look like in a way that you now cannot even appear or come out. because you don't like yourself. You dislike yourself. You don't like your appearance. One of the most powerful teachings of this deen is that identity is given by Allah. الَّذِي خَلَقَكَ فَسَوَّاكَ فَعَدَلَكَ فِي أَيِّ صُورَةٍ مَا شَاءَ رَكَّبَكَ. Allah put you together in whatever shape He decided to put you together for a reason, as a test for you and as a test for those who gave birth to you and a test for those around you who are going to interact with you. If someone is challenged, what we would say disabled in one way or another, or maybe having some physical or mental challenges, it's a test for those who gave birth to them. Are they going to bear patience? Are they going to love their child still, unconditionally, given what may, meaning come what may? And those who interact with them later on, are they going to treat them fairly in an appropriate, proper, befitting manner? Or are they going to laugh and scoff at them? If they're going to laugh and scoff, then obviously you're losing the plot. If you see someone who's abnormal, or should I say challenged or disabled, there are so many ways of actually referring to them, whatever it may be. If you see someone of that nature, it's the sunnah to say Alhamdulillah alladhi faddalani ala kathirin mimman khalaqa tafdeelan. All praise is due to Allah who has given me virtue over those whom He has created on different levels of virtue. So Allah's blessed them in a different way, and Allah's blessed you in a different way, and He's raised you in a certain way. So, and Allah may have raised them in another way. So this dua is thanking Allah for what He's bestowed upon you. But don't belittle and don't laugh at them, because Allah can actually test you or someone close to you with something like that or worse. So always go out of your way to look out for those who might be tested and challenged in a different way. But don't pick on yourself and think, I'm not normal, this is not normal, that's not normal. People don't notice these things. You need to liberate yourself by loving yourself the way you are made, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People are different sizes, people are different shapes, people have different skin tones, different textures, whatever it may be. For as long as it was not caused by you and your own hands doing, you always love yourself. If you did it yourself, then you may share, or you have to share, part of or most of that particular blame. Allah disallows us to mutilate our bodies. Allah disallows us to cause any harm to our bodies, because ultimately they're not our bodies. They are Allah. They belong to Allah, these bodies. He's temporarily loaned them to us. He says, take this. A few years' time, when I separate the soul again, we'll take this back. And we're going to just see how you use it. Don't pierce it, don't, meaning there's certain things you don't do with it, don't do these permanent tattoos and so on. All this is part of Islamic teaching. So we shouldn't do to our bodies what we're not allowed to do. Keep it clean, keep it pure, keep it well looked after, because Allah's going to take it back. May Allah Almighty make it easy for us. Obviously, I haven't gone into the details of the rulings of piercings and tattoos, but you can find that out, inshallah. What I'm more interested in today is dealing with the difficulty of not even appreciating what Allah has blessed you with. He's blessed you. If people don't like you because of what you look like, trust me, they're not worthy of being your friends or interacting with. Necessity. They are uneducated. They don't have a connection with Allah. No one's taught them. And this is why I always say, let us not treat others in a different manner. Just because this person happens to have a certain tone of skin, we treat them in a different way. People do that. And sometimes without thinking, they do that. We want to become conscious of it. Go out of your way to be kind to everyone, and Allah will bless you. But my brothers and sisters, just love the way Allah made you. That's when you will be liberated. You don't have to plaster yourself with a ton of makeup before you love what you look like, because that's not you. Just love yourself, the original you. May Allah bless you. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد